Hey, what's going on, everybody? Red Rhino Music here, bringing you another video. Today we're back on NASCAR Heat 3 to do the goal bowling at the Glen at Watkins Glen. Watkins Glen is personally one of my favorite tracks. It's in every game that I play, every racing game, I mean. I just love it. I'm used to it. I know it. This game, it's a little weird. Everything's a little scaled differently and stuff, and this car doesn't really have brakes on it for some reason, so I really have to, like, engine brake to get the thing to slow down, but I'm actually pretty okay with our car right now. Anyways, let's get it. I don't really know what to expect from the bots for this race. I haven't really seen them. Like, in the practice they were there, but they were just kind of hanging out.
We're going green.
This is gonna be different with the race, so let's see what happens.
Green set, let's go. Left side.
I'm not even gonna put it to fourth because we don't need it.
Left side.
I lit up early just to see where the bots were gonna go.
Left side.
Oh, we just got ran into. See, this is the only problem I have with this track in this game, is this uphill is completely wrong. Like, it feels wrong. Because you have to do things, like, you have to lift and stuff where normally you wouldn't really have to. And I guess you could argue, like, oh, it's a low downforce car and stuff, so it's gonna feel different, but I've driven stuff like this before on Watkins Glen, and it's not like that. Car will get, like, looser. It won't tighten up like that, though.
Stay right. Still there. Clear all around. Right side.
Well, Watkins Glen is definitely one of my favorite tracks. It's just, there's something about it. Like, some sections flow well, other sections are very technical. It's a great balance.
White flag, bring it home.
Only 2 laps per stage, what?
Stay right, please. Still there.
Oh, I forgot to mention where we started, by the way, in case you weren't looking at it. We started in, like, 25th or something like that. Normally, I always say that in the beginning, but for some reason, I just skipped over it. I guess I wanted to just race. Get around Kligerman here. Get some draft on McMurray. We're still wicked fast for some reason. It makes sense for something like this, because I kind of know where you push what and what's going to happen where. And a little different on here than an oval. At least for me. My background's mostly road stuff, so.
Careful, still there.
What I wanted to do was kind of shoot up the inside and maybe push Almirola, but we weren't getting the grip that we needed, or at least the turn in.
No points that stage, but plenty of races left.
Alright, I guess there was a caution, because this is where the finish line actually is, where we just went over, so. Do not pit. Let's get it. We already gained 7 spots, maybe? 6 spots?
Carter has the green flag in his hand. Be ready?
Why are we starting all the way out here?
Right side. Clear all around. Couple more turns. Two more. Two to go.
Still gonna take it easy, just because you never know. Still don't really have a judge of where they break for that.
Think tight there, driver. Hold this line here. Stay right. All right, careful now. Still there.
But, like, the way this car handles on the uphill is kind of the opposite of what it actually would do. Because if you don't have downforce, your car is loose. It's not tight. It's kind of driving there like we have too big of a wing. Got a little bit into McMurray, got us a little sideways. A little hectic on the downshift, gave it too much gas too soon. 2 laps for this stage as well. I'm assuming stage 3 is going to be 4 laps maybe.
left side.
It's interesting on here, though, because we are faster than them, for sure. Like, if you just look at how fast we catch up to somebody. But I still can't really use it, because it's such a tight track. I feel like we're in a LMP car and these guys are in GT3. Missed that turn completely. Well, sorted out. My bad. That's the braking I'm talking about. I don't know if you're supposed to try to keep them hot, because I'm literally not braking ever. Except for two or three spots. So I don't know if they're not up to temperature, so we don't have any grip in them or like bite. Trying to warm them up a little bit. But we straight up have like no brake pressure. It's like I'm not even doing it. So I do have to kind of throw it in down a gear to get it to slow down a little bit. Damn it, tried to get between both of them. Tried to split it.
Clear to your right.
See, we still barely made that. And I'm braking a lot.
Nice drive at that stage. No points. Good job.
We're doing all right, though. We're gaining spots here. This is a quick race.
All right.
70 laps here for this stage. Seven. Well, technically eight. That's a lot more than I thought it was gonna be. I thought it was gonna be four.
Careful, still there.
See, it's weird. We have brake right there.
Clear all around.
But it's like if we're going fast, our brakes just don't grab. It's not like we're not slowing down in time or anything. It's just not doing anything. I guess they want you to really lift or something. I like the dirt physics or effects, I guess, when they hit these corners too hard.
Right side.
You guys are taking the turn wrong.
Stay to your right. Still there.
All right, Hamlin. You want to just sit there all day? Go along to Kurt Busch because of our lack of brakes. It's like the brakes don't work in fourth gear. I guess. They work fine in third.
Stay left. Careful. Still there. Clear right. Left side's clear. Left side.
Okay. Thanks, Kurt Busch. Ooh. Touched the curb a little bit.
Right.
We're all right, though.
Still there. Right side.
I'm a little paranoid about this chicane thing, because I don't really know how much room the bots are gonna give us, or what their, like, lane is for it, really. Can't get what I want out of this car. At least right there, in that turn.
You're
supposed to kinda go wide and come back in, like, super close, so you're already going up to speed in this section.
Clear all around.
Oh, they want me to just let off the gas too much.
Clear. All
right, we're going down here. There's like no room for us to make moves right now. This four-car pack we got. All right, we're going to the inside.
Hang tight there, driver. Hold this line here. Left side.
Come on, give us room. Like, yeah, I know that's risky and stuff, but, like, they didn't react to me being there. Like, don't, you can't turn in if I'm there. Like, whether or not you like me being there, I still have that spot. I'm pretty sure I was in front of him. Whatever. It's not a sim, it's not online, I don't really care. Alright, send it. Like, right there. They just kind of go inside anyway, even if I'm there. Like, I'm really holding my line. The only place I wouldn't complain is, like, right there. That's my fault. And it's because I'm trying to, like, deal with this car doing two different things at the same time. Like, the car both understeers and oversteers there, depending on what you're doing. My bad, it's all understeer bringing us out. I just can't get this thing to turn anymore. They want you literally never to touch the gas in a turn. We could do this right now. We could get this win, too. I'm clean and I push this thing hard. We need to pass Elliot right now. We need to be on third. No turn in again. I had to risk it for the biscuit. Oh, we got a caution. What's this going to be, one lap? Or are we doing two? I had to risk it. I had to risk it. I wasn't going to not go for the win. And we had to get by Elliot for that. And the car just didn't want to stop for us. Okay. We could still do it. Like, right there, they wanted us to lift coming out of that. Like, my ass, you're not doing that there. Nobody lifts there. That's like a very... You'd have to be in something so fast to not have to lift there. Or, I mean, to have to actually lift there. P2. Come on, dig, driver. Clear all around. See, like, look at that. We can't turn in unless I downshift. But I can't really go for the downshift either, because it's going to make our car spaz out. Alright, Larson, we're coming for you, buddy. I'm not going to be able to do it right here. See, that's where I'd want some more steering ratio. Or, I mean, a tighter steering ratio. Alright, we're cheating. Nobody saw it. The race director didn't see it, we're good. Doing it again. Nobody saw it. Oh, it's a battle right now.
Left side's clear. Ooh. Black and right, waving in the air. That's the checkered flag. Good job.
That's another win. Now, I'll be honest with you. We probably wouldn't have got that if I didn't try to cheat and use a little more track than we were allowed to. But, I mean... did we get a penalty, though? Why would you do a burnout here? There's literally no room for it. I was just really nervous that they were going to throw a caution or something or end it early like they always do before we got to the finish line, because I did not have him under that Monster Energy sign. And that's where they were calling it before. Bit of a rough race for us. Got into a lot of contact, had a couple mistakes and stuff, but it's just so weird doing this stuff on this game. Like, iRacing or Project Cars, it would have been a different story, but this is just something else. It's weird. Anyways, though, that's another win in our book. We're up to, like, 6 now. We're doing good. My experience on this track definitely helped out a lot. Because even though the game doesn't really sync up with any other racing game or anything, and, like, it's scaled a little different and stuff, and it still kind of helps. Like, I know where the track is, I know where you're really supposed to be, and certain lines that these bots aren't doing. If you guys like seeing NASCAR Heat 3 on the channel, make sure you hit that like button down below to let me know. Got into some contact there, that's when we got in that big wreck. And if you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button as well so you get notified for when I upload new videos. Thanks for watching, guys. See y'all next time. Peace.